Cheers from Ohio. Marsh Rat here. Today I'm going to show you a new garage project, how to convert a used dog kennel into a live trap. So stick with me and I'll step you through what I've done. This is not necessarily a DIY project or a how-to, it's what I've done. I won't show you all the steps, but I'll show you some of the little obstacles that I've overcome. As with the dog kennels, the door swings this way, and it's got a latch on it right here. For my trap, I wanted the door to swing down like this under its own weight, and then latch itself. So the first problem I run into was converting this latch into a mechanism that when it slammed shut would lock itself. So the first thing I did is took the latch apart and installed a spring that would always force the latch into a closed position. Next thing I did is took my grinder and ground an angle on the bottom of the latch such that when the door slams, the spring forces it to latch. I also put a little piece of paracord here to keep this from swinging around. Something like this. The next thing I had to consider was how do I trip the trap and close the door? In looking at most of the commercially available traps, I like the idea of having a treadle. So when the animal comes in, their weight pushes the treadle and drips the mechanism. But most of them I saw had their mechanism, besides the treadle, came out on the exterior of the trap and went that way. And what that tells me is a curious coon or other animal may paw at that mechanism trying to get to the bait and accidentally trip the mechanism prematurely. So I wanted something internal to the trap. So what I came up with is a bar, or actually a piece of wire that comes up from the treadle up to the mechanism here. And if you can see this, when the trap is triggered, when the treadle is pushed down, there's a piece of wire that comes up that pushes this rod down, or pulls this rod down like that. So that keeps the entire treadle and the trip mechanism interior to the trap. So from the release mechanism, I've just got a piece of wire that runs up and holds the door in place. Now, this wire is really just a coat hanger. This is a piece of coat hanger wire. This is a body washer, but I think now in retrospect, I thought it was cool to begin with, but in retrospect, I could have just extended this coat hanger with a loop for that. So, I don't know, the beers were kicking in at that design point, I guess. So after I had my treadle, release mechanism, attached the door, figured out. Next big obstacle was adjusting the sensitivity. This door is pretty heavy. And what I had to do is balance my attachment point to my door to the weight of my treadle. and get it to, I'd say hit a trigger within a pound, maybe a little bit less than that. So that ended up pretty cool. I did put some loops, wire hoop loops here, just to hold this wire in place, keep it from dangling around when I moved it. The next mods that I did was thinking like, trying to think like the animal. You notice the openings in the original dog kennel is probably, looks like about 10 inches by 2. And obviously I think a coon can probably get his paw in there. So what I did is put some this, what do you call this, metal wood around the entire perimeter on the back so he can't get his paw in there and accidentally trip my mechanism. The next thing I did, you'll notice this tube going up through here, it actually contains the wire. And I figured when a coon gets in here or some animal, he's going to go ballistic, and I didn't want him bending my wire. So I took a piece of brake line that I had laying around the garage and just simply cut a piece of flat stock, slipped the brake line over top of my wire. That way I give it a little extra protection. You know, if I was in a cage, thank God I've never been in jail, but if I was in a cage, I'd probably go ballistic after a while. So it just gives my wire a little extra protection. The only other design consideration I point out is if I made this piece of wire here one piece continuous that goes all the way back to the trigger, then notice what happens when the door comes down right here, it would bend your wire. So I simply made two pieces of wire right there that would hinge without bending. Well, thanks for watching. Hopefully you found this video interesting or at least entertaining. Cheers from Ohio.